Hello, YouTube! I am Pinstar, and this is Tropico 6 Strategy and Tactics, rebooted episode 5, I think. I'm losing count already. Anyway, so in our last episode, we find ourselves at the tail end of the colonial era, with the clock kind of ticking here. And we want to make sure we, well, don't lose, obviously, because that would make this a very short series. One of the precautions I'm going to take here, since there's only a little tiny bit left on here, we're going to cancel this Rome contract. And let's see, no Rome contract with the crown, but there is a gold contract with the crown. And we are exporting gold actively, so just in case they ask us for a trade route, we can fulfill that pretty quickly. Right then, let us kick things off. Oh yes, we were destroying this little area here. And, yeah, we've got our library here. We could probably do another one if we really wanted to. Generally speaking, a one library to one mansion is a good ratio. Because if you pay max on the library, you'll get these people being rich and will help their families afford that. And if they marry into someone who isn't a librarian, they'll still be able to live in luxury. And yeah, we could use two libraries worth of people, doing their thing. I do like me some science. Science! Let's see here. Oh yeah, is this thing done yet? No, we're still clearing out those woods. Let's actually place the mansion first, because we can squeeze, yeah, a mansion right here. Should probably do, like, two mansions right here. And then our library numero duos. Yeah, I guess we could do a library over here, or we could do it here, although that would smush. No, actually, that wouldn't even fit. Never mind smushing. Yeah, we'll do it right there. That's nestled nicely enough. All right, so let's kick things up a notch here. How are you guys doing? All right, 17k left there, 17k left there.
I need
another one? You and your damn coconuts. Man, you know what? They must be trying to get back the coconuts we keep stealing from our raids. We just keep selling them back to them. Trade route completed. Yeah, that gold trade route is probably, well, since we know that's not it, we can go for more. We can go for the ultra rich one again. They won't like us for it, but that's okay. We'll live, I hope. And once again, we're gonna see if we can't take this to the bridge, as it were, not have to bother building a coconut harvester. But if we do, I'll quick build it again. I mean, I could just demolish this one, but whatever. I'll see if I can avoid that. All right, edicts are cooking away, and yeah, we're just accumulating research at this point, which is what I want to do. I don't actually want to be actively researching anything, because I'm pretty much done with everything that's needed in the colonial era. And I want to save my cash, for the most part, for our big expansion burst into the World War era, because we've got a lot of things to accomplish once that era rolls around. You do want to try to, I swear, guys, come on. You want to try and make your way into the World War era as richly as possible. That at the very least lets you get right into industries. If you like our original game, come into World War era at a decent, modest amount of money, that's still okay because you can just do a burst of more raw material gathering. And then that will ultimately make, get your economy bootstrapped. You know, it had they not kiboshed our save game, I still think our... oh, perfect. Yes, 10 revolutionary immigrants just in time for the boat to show up, too.
The people of Tropico love you almost
sweet.
As much as I do, Governor. We have such exquisite taste.
Yes, and given our cash money, we are going to...
Excellent. I knew you had a good head on your shoulders. My heart swells with joy as I greet my fearless leader for the first time as El Presidente.
All right. Now, because we were able to buy our way out, I am going to go the same constitution bits here. All citizens vote and pacifist state. Because if we didn't have to buy military, why bother? Now, if you were doing military, if you had to actually fight off an invasion, I would go professional soldiers and probably either wealthy citizens vote or open ballot to take advantage of the fact that a rebel or two is not going to really bother you. But no, I'll take that for the superpower relations boosts. So we got 12 people, but... nothing was ready for export? Alright, whatever. Okay, we've got a lot to work ahead of us. We have a lot of work ahead of us. First things first, let's check our trade routes. Meat, milk. Well, we could do meat. No sugar. No tobacco. So we don't have it. We don't have cotton. We're not making steel. We could make steel. What's our almanac looking like? We've got 21 unemployed citizens. We're going to be fixing that toot sweet. We're going to be expanding that greatly. We could culminate something with the Allies here. And actually, we could pick up that steel thing, because steel is one of the industries I'm looking to get myself into. Just because we're squeezing our whole place like an orange. So we might as well start exporting it. And actually, I saw someone who was willing to import some coal. 2,400? Nah, let's tap that ourselves. And nobody wants that. Weapons, no. Okay. But at the very least, we got steel, and you know what? We got meat. I think we are going to be going allies this particular run, even though it is a bit tougher to make that work for us, because we'd have to stop looting and start rescuing four times to become their allies. But I think we can pull it off, especially with the economy we've got set up here. But first things first, let us get ourselves a coal mine. We're gonna just start tapping into this area hardcore. So we've got two iron mines rolling. We're gonna get three coal mines rolling here as well. This will take care of our immediate unemployment issues. Go. Ain't necessarily going to be the prettiest, but it rarely is with these. Actually, are there any other, I think there are other mines up here. Yes, iron. So yeah, we can really get into, we can seriously get into some steel here. We are going to squeeze that peninsula like a, like an orange. that's going to be sort of our first economic foray. Now, we have a longer-term gambit in mind with the lumber, but right now, my focus is going to be on steel. Now, let me remind myself, industry, steel mills, not that bad. Does require educated people, but it's definitely worth the cost of admission here. Especially once we start getting coal up and running. Yeah. And then steel plus nickel let us get weapons factory, which is an interesting take on that as well. Now, it is really stupidly expensive. Like, really, really expensive. But there's a bunch of other industries that I kind of want to get into as well. Let's see here. I think, you know what? I do think it would actually make a lot of sense to have the steel mills up here, because this is kind of the nexus for it all. Yeah, we got iron that's going to need to get transported up here, but ultimately speaking, that's fine. So let us buy the blueprint to our friend the steel mill, and we are going to kick off our friend. We're actually going to be building a whole ton of factories here, but we're not going to finish them right away. What we do want to do is kick off the industrialization edict. That costs us a pretty penny, but now it cuts the cost of all of our factories in half. So now we can drop a pair of steel mills here. There we go, beautiful. The other thing that we're going to do here is we're going to be prepping for a lumber industry. But this is going to be a longer term prep for it. Actually, let me take a look here. February 1910. If we, let's give it a year, because we need to set up more stuff. So we got steel, we got meat. We're going to go whole hog on the Allies. We're not making any milk, to sell them. That's okay though. I'm not going to stop doing the rum, so sorry, guys. You know, I guess what we could do... We could import nickel. I mean, nickel's expensive, though. But we could use that to make weapons. Do we go the nickel route and make weapons? Is anybody buying... The Axis are buying weapons. Well, that's actually not that good of a... Yeah, they really want weapons, but, no. You're not paying me that much of a premium for them, so you ain't getting a premium.
Call me now. I don't want to alarm you.
Let's see here. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it. We'll put off our lumber industry until a little bit later. We'll just go with our heavy hitting stuff. So weapons factory. Now this is kind of dangerous to get into, only because we don't actually have a local supply of nickel, at least not in the vicinity. Let me just check. Do we have nickel all the way over here? Not really that accessible. Yeah, this is... That's... If we're going to rely on imported nickel. Or we could do nickel raids. What is... No, those are trade routes. Actually, that might be a smart idea, is to start switching to... I keep hitting the trade routes. Let's see. Fish, nickel, and tobacco. Interesting combination. The fish, eh. But the nickel. Nickel is definitely worth it. So we can start We can start queuing up nickel heists, at least until we get we need to start doing rescues. So one weapons factory right here. And ultimately, at the end of the day, this is all temporary, because once the mines dry up and the steel dries up, that's going to be problematic. Right then. So, but again, it's a transformative economy. We do have some money left that we do need to invest at home. A couple of things we want to do here. First things first, we are going to demolish all these taverns and these and these. We've got some replacements to do here. Let's kick up, these for just a moment. Let them empty out, disappear. Good. Let me get that one too. Now, one of the things I've been kind of experimenting with here is the... Where is it? No, not that, not that. Let's see. The Botanical Garden. This thing is kind of big, like the circus, but... That looks like we do have to smush that. Actually, it's a little bit bigger, more sizable than I bargained for. 1, 2, 3, 4. Those would still fit. We'd lose out on the newspaper, but at the moment, that's actually not the worst thing in the world. So we're gonna scrap the newspaper for the moment. We'll do something about it. We also need to scrap the chapel. We also will be replacing that, because we got to make room for the botanical garden. Now, my reasoning for the botanical garden is twofold. One is it's a high capacity entertainment building, but two is that it has a broke wealth requirement, allowing everybody to get in there, even the people that end up, well, broke. All right, let's get our church, right here. And then we can get ourselves a clinic, also very critical. In fact, I might do... Well, I know I'm going to do one right here. The other thing I do want to do is make sure we get ourselves that fire station. I'm going to put the fire station up here, because this stuff is ultimately more valuable than any of that other junk. And with before we go broke here, let's get... Oh, we could do an embassy. Yeah, we can afford an embassy. That way we can start properly brown-nosing it up with the allies. In the wealthier area, that's fine. You guys still haven't been tapped into. So yeah, now we've got some very, very busy construction office people. I might kick you guys up to ignore. Really? I guess we're quick building that. That didn't take long, game. I barely had a chance to breathe. The heck's on fire? Oh, seriously? The gold mine is on fire. Effing lovely. You guys better be able to, Yeah, you guys aren't even getting Teamsters picking your stuff up. Alright, we need more Teamsters here. That is a certainty right there. Yeah, that should be good. Teamsters office. Again, gotta keep them near the houses. Oh, the fire stopped. How kind of it. Oh no, not my shack. Whatever shall I do? You guys are building the steel mills first, aren't you? Alright, you know what? If you're going to build those steel mills first, let's get to importing coal. Not enough funds. Dang. Alright, at least we should get some kind of a payday here.
Flying cars have arrived in Tropico.
There we go.
Flight times are less than a second, but our scientists are working hard on improving that.
Alright, we'll get just a temporary influx of coal. That should be good for now. Yeah, we'll invite the allies, make them our friends. We'll do our nickel raids for the moment, and then we'll go to rescues, and then we'll switch back to nickel raids. Oh yeah, research. What do we want first? We could do the prohibition again. That's not the worst thing in the world, and certainly would help us out. We can also start working on our other stuff. You know what? Let's just work on the big ticket items for the moment. If I decide otherwise, we can always pivot. We'll just let this area continue to grow itself. While we're destroying the environment wholesale in one part of the island, we are actually going to be doing good by it in another. Yeah, ignore safety regulations.
I am inspired. I have.
Okay. We'll take that. We will eventually be building a police station. Not high on our priority list at the moment. Oh, one thing I do want to quick build is that clinic. And we will,
Let's face it, it's better to be one of the allies than one of the.
Oh, hey!
An ally instead of.
Wow, a freebie.
We must.
Invite the allies. Well, let's see. How about that? And we'll praise you. We could go right for the alliance before asking for financial aid. Eh, why not?
Good show. Not bad at all. Almost worthy of an Englishman, I'd say.
Let's go with the secret stuff, because we can start making some real
Everyone
good
has friends, right, Prez?
Produce meat? Yeah, we can produce meat. That'll give us even more. Thank you for that easy one, my friend. Right. We can send a delegation.
Let's face it, it's better to be one of the allies than one of the Axis. You get to be an ally instead of, well, an axe.
All right, there we go. We need to do our rescues. So we might as well queue up our rescues. What's the protest?
Your supreme leadership.
Yeah, health, nice. Happiness. I figured that's what that was, and that's why I wanted to rush by that. Let's see here. Wow, you're already up to 19K. Nice. Let's see here. Oh yeah, Pirate Cove. Alright, we need to do rescues, don't we? Okay, you know what? We're gonna do 4 education rescues and then go right the heck back to Nickel. We'll let them finish the one nickel raid first, just to help seed things. And ask for financial aid. There we go. Cash money in the bank.
Do any of these offers look good to you?
Ooh, all right. We can just flat out buy labor policy. We'll grab that, and yeah, we'll open up the new slots. Yeah, that's fine. We'll wait for them to refresh themselves. But yeah, buying a labor policy lets us do that once we flip the Constitution.
The palace replies, vote el presidente in the next election.
Now we still have our industry edict on, which means we can actually start doing our lumber industry too. You know, you might be saying, Pinstar, what lumber industry? You don't have any wood. What the heck are you doing, Pinstar? Pinstar, you are a madman. No, but I've got a plan. A plan. I am a man with a plan, and it involves these islands here. I just need to measure out the bridge here. Or see if I can't make it happen. Uneven terrain. There's gotta be a way to make this work for us. Unless it doesn't like us sending bridges off on these little areas. Yeah, because this is just the little area here. We got a fishing spot, we got that. Still yelling us for uneven terrain, but if we make a bridge, say, here, it's too long. Well, let's try this way. No? I'll fight with this later on, over time. But my goal is to get people over there, one way or another. If I have to smush the fishing port here, then I will. Are you guys keeping up here? Good. Keep that gold a-flowing, please. What is with the angry music, game? Come on. I'm gonna do a second thing here.
Amazing meteor.
Were blown up by it. Ooh. Limit refugee. Welp, looks like we're getting meteor showers. But I can actually make use of these refugees at this point. Not like 11 billion. We're going to need to. Game, please.
An official statement from the palace confirms a meteor shower is going to narrowly miss Tropico. El Presidente asks for your gratitude for
your statement is full of crap, my friend. Full of complete and utter crap. Your statement means nothing. Alright, now these guys are technically here. Alright, good, yeah, get out there and fight them fires, please. What else is on fire? Hopefully it's just some stupid shacks. Oh, that. Alright, not too much damage, all said and done. But since we're going to be getting a butt ton of refugees, let's initiate at least the garden level phase of this project here. And that is ring around the rosying here with lumber mills. Because the whole point of this thing is to produce trees for these lumber mills to sustainably log. I know this isn't great green area for it now, but it will be over time. So we're going to make our own fertile lumber ground here, plant our own forest to cut down sustainably. We'll get into the rest of the industry in due time, in actually the next episode. So if you guys like this episode and you want to see more like it, go ahead and hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and leave me a comment, good, bad, or indifferent. Your feedback is always welcome. So until next time, this has been Pinstar signing out. See ya!